black belt. Refuse my skills and knowledge only for what is right. And to make the principles of effort, etiquette, sincerity, character, and self-control a part of my daily life. Cool. Step up and bow. Right foot out. Hands up and pull. Ah! All right, let's just get ourselves warmed up at least. Cool. And let's rotate our arms while we're jogging. And backwards. Cool, and crossing. Good, okay, let's do our 10 jumping jacks. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, cool. I'm gonna let you pick some strikes and kicks to warm us up, okay? So what strike do you wanna do first?
Probably elbow. Downward elbow.
Elbow, okay, that's a good one. All right, here we go. Ready? One.
Oh, I meant
that. Downward elbow. I'm sorry. Okay, I gotcha. Okay, here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. That's a good one. I always forget to do that one in warm-ups. I like that. Okay, pick another one.
Front snap kick.
Okay, that'll work. Make sure you got room. Hands up. And one. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, and ten. All right, jump switch. And other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, nine, ten. Good, all right. Are you warmed up? Okay, I'm warmed up too. All right, let's grab our weapon. Okay, so this is the traditional Japanese sword cutting set that Professor Chamberlain has taught me, and he's taught Shihan Roland, and not very many of the students know it. I think Shihan Roland teaches it during summer camps sometimes. That's why I wasn't sure if you had it, because if you do summer camps, then Shihan Roland likes to teach it there. But not many of the students that don't go to summer camps have it. So it's just a cool, it's not on your curriculum, it's not required, but if you were ever to go to the tournament and want to do a weapons kata, you could do this one. And that was it. Okay? All right, so I'm going to take mine out. Well, actually, no. I'm not going to do that. Okay. So we are going to start. Also, when you hold your weapon, you're going to pretend like you have a guard on it like this, okay? Can you see the guard?
Okay. Yeah.
So the one hand goes up underneath the guard, and the other hand is separated underneath it. They're not together. They're separate because you have to be able to push and pull hands, okay? Push, pull. So you can't have them together because you don't have as much control. So separate, separate, okay? So we're going to start with the sword in our belt. Okay, and it goes on your left hand side. Because if you're right-handed, you need to draw from the left hand side. Okay? Sensei, are you gonna do this one with us, or do you have a stick? You don't have to. Okay. I wasn't sure. Have you done this one before?
No.
No. Okay, cool. Okay, so you might have to let me know if there's better angles for you guys, because I just tried to do this with my Good Shepherd class and they were all over the place. So let's see how it works here. The first thing you're gonna do, okay, we bow. This is the traditional Japanese bow, okay, straight down like that. So just straight forward, okay. First move is you're going to, if it's in your belt, you're going to kind of pop it forward this way and turn it so that you get it ready to draw, okay? So we bow, turn, and kind of pop the sword out a little bit so it's ready to go. Then you're gonna step in with your right foot and draw, okay? As you draw, you're gonna cut straight across and finish with that blade straight out to your side. Straight out to your side. Yep. Okay, so go back and do that one more time. Okay, so it's here. We bow. And get this ready. Okay, step in with your right foot and draw. Cut. Good. So, Evan, don't let it go way back behind you. It's straight out to the side. Yeah. So if I'm in front of you, it looks like this. Okay? Is that angle better? Does that angle help more, Evan?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I just don't have as much room in that direction, but okay, so now we've got it out to the side. Now we're going to bring it up over your head. Now you've got it with your left hand. Step forward two steps. Cut. Straight down in front. So from the side, this is what it looks like. You're here, bring it up, around, step, step, cut. Okay? So from here, bring it up, step, step, cut. Straight up and down. Straight up and down. Okay? Let me see your cut, Evan.
So, wait, like,
start, cut to the side, good.
Okay.
Yeah, you guys can start with in your belt, and then let me see what it looks like. Good. Step in with your right foot and cut, good. Forward, cut down. So, Evan, instead of putting your hands out like this, I want your cut, look how my arms are. I want you to cut down like that. Yes. Yes. So remember, it's a samurai sword, right? So you're cutting down to here. But don't let it go too low. It's cut straight to there, okay? All right, so the next, let's go to the beginning and then we'll do the next part, okay? Go back to the beginning. Okay, here. Okay, so bow, get it ready. Step, drop. Then bring it up. Step, step, straight up and down. The next move, you're going to look over your left shoulder. There's a bad guy over there. You're going to cut from bottom to the top at an angle.
I think so I might have to. So, like, once you're like this, you go.
That's the, no. So you're like this, see? You're here, you look to the guy over to your side, and it's going up. Yes, like that.
That's what I did over here, it's just it was kind of at a different angle.
Oh, gotcha, okay, yes. So we just went up. So we cut all the way through the guy's shoulder, okay? Now, while it's up here, you're gonna turn the blade. Yep, and cut down at the same angle. Good, since I missed that part. So let's go back to, it's okay. So let's go to the cutting depth. So we went cut it down, okay? Look over to your left, the guy's right here. You're cutting up at the angle. So you're in a, you basically should be in a front stance facing this wall now with your left leg in front, and you just cut up at an angle at a 45. Now you're gonna turn the blade and cut down at the 45. Yeah, and you want kind of your right hand, your right arm straight and your left hand bent at that point. On this one, it's way up over your head, turn, cut down, okay?
And then should your hands cross?
Kind of, so I'm cutting up, they're not crossed, but now when I turn it over, my hands are, I mean, they're kind of crossed as you get back down here.
The start of your hands are crossed, like kind of right here.
Yeah, little bits. It's just, it's an odd angle when you finish there, yeah. Okay, so we go, cutting down, look to your left, step a little bit with your left foot, cut up, turn the blade, cut down. Good. Then we're going to look behind us. The next guy is behind us. We're going to step with our right foot. Cut up at the angle. Now you are going to be a little bit crossed. See my shoulders in the way of my face. Turn the blade. Cut down. Yes. So we just took care of three guys right there. So let's go back to the beginning. Let me know if you have questions. Oh, you have a Boken. That's handy. Okay. So, let me try to do this angle for you. Okay. So bow, and get your blade ready. And then we step, draw. Bring it up, step, cut it down.
Okay, I got it.
What's that?
Okay. I got it.
Look to your left, cut up. Turn the blade, cut down. Go behind you, step with your right foot, step up. So, Sensei, your right hand wants to be on top, and it's straight. I can't tell if that's your right hand.
Like this?
I'm just looking at you funky. Yes, okay, good, and then turn it. Cut down. So those are all at 45 degrees. Now, you're going to take your right hand, turn it over. Okay, so your hand is like this. Now
it's like this.
Now you're going to turn it over. Step forward with your left foot. Bring your elbow up. And you're going to poke behind you. And then bring it back. So you have to keep your elbow up and out of, so I'm going to do it from this angle, okay? So I had, so I just finished my strike down here, okay? My sword is here. I turn my hand over. I step forward with my left leg. The guy's not there. I have to give myself room. Now I'm going to stab him. Pull it back out. So that's all left foot. Okay? Clear's mud? You got that, Evan?
Uh-huh.
Good. Okay, that looks good. Okay, let's go back to the beginning. Okay, bow. And get your sword ready. Step forward. Draw. Step in. Cut. Look to your left. Cut up. Turn the blade, cut down. Look behind you, shift, cut up. Turn the blade, cut down. Turn your right hand over, shift forward, step behind you, pull it out. Now you're going to, okay, I'm gonna have to turn sideways for this. Now you're going to need to turn your left hand over. You're going to switch your feet and stagger.
Okay. So like this?
So the guy that you took care of over here, now you're stabbing him. And it's not straight up and down. It's kind of out at an angle.
Okay. Like this one?
Yes. Yes. So you're stabbing him, and then you have to pull it back out. Yeah. Okay. Sensei, where did we leave you? I see you're wrangling kids too.
Keith is back, so Kieran is now not holding on to this as it. So
I couldn't see that he was doing.
Yes, I tried to swing it, and he'd be like, "Woo!"
Oh. You're like, that's not working out for me.
Plus, okay, I don't let's have go my, back. My dining room table is usually pushed over there, so I could do this, but.
Gotcha.
Okay. Got before this, so.
Okay, let's do from the beginning. All right, so bow. Oops. And get the sword ready. Step out. Cut. Step in. Cut down. Look to your left. Shift. Cut up. Turn the blade, cut down. Look behind you, shift, cut up. Turn the blade, cut down. Turn your right hand over, shift forward, stand behind you, bring it out. Turn your left hand over, switch your feet, now your right foot's in front, stab the guy in front of you, pull it out. And then I don't have a lot of room, but after this, what you're gonna do, watch my hands. So my hands are both pointed down like this. You're gonna take your right hand and put it upside down, okay? So your right hand's gonna go upside down. You're gonna step back with your right foot and chaburi. Chaburi means clearing the blood away. So it's a flick, okay? So you take the weapon and flick off to the side behind you, okay? So we have right foot in front, pull it out, do your chaburi as you step back with your left foot. Okay, so now you're here. Now you're going to step back with your right foot, bring your sword over, put it away, but not all the way away, just a little bit out still. Now step back, lock it in, and then back. And that's the whole thing, the cutting set. So it's pretty short and it's pretty fun and it teaches you the basic cuts. The basic cuts, so that's helpful to have that. So let's go from the beginning. Is it better if I'm facing this way or if I'm facing sideways? Like what works best? Any thoughts? What's that? No thoughts. Okay.
I think generally if you're facing away from us, but it kind of depends on the part, you know.
Some sections I'm like, you need to see my hands here.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Okay. I'm going to have to work on getting this. I'm going to have this situated on actually a safe that's in just in the middle of the floor of the room. So I'm going to have to get it squished, pushed back, and then I'll have more room to maneuver. Okay. All right, so let's go from the beginning. There is an alternate way you can start this kata, and that's if you wanted to start it from your knees. You can start from here. You can do your traditional bow like we do in grappling. Okay? And then from here, you go here. From down here, you step up and draw as you step to your knee, and then as you step up. Okay, so you could do it from your knee too if you wanted. My floors are super uncomfortable, so I'm not a fan of that, but. So just know that you would draw as you step up with that right knee, right? So you're down here, draw, and then step up. You wanna try that, Evan?
Kind of, sure, yeah.
Okay, so, because Sensei's trying it, so you try it.
I can't go see me. I'm going to have to go back.
Okay, perfect. So bow, good. So draw as you, nope, other right knee.
Oh, right knee?
Yeah, because if you bring your left knee up, Evan, you will chop your kneecap off. You don't want to do that. Oh. Yeah. So right knee up as you draw. Good. Now step up. One, two. One more step forward. Yeah. You have to finish with your right leg in front. So watch my feet from here. Let me tilt it down so you can see my feet. Okay. Can we see my feet? Okay. From here, I can't draw because I'm too close to the wall, but draw and then step forward, left, right. That's where I'm going to shake. Okay? Yeah. Yep. So you want to bring the blade here. Okay. It's out to your side. Bring the blade all the way up and then come straight down. Okay. Let it go all the way around and up over your head. Yeah. Good. Okay, let's go from the beginning. So, bow and get your sword ready. Step in. Cut. Step forward. Cut down. Look to your left. Cut up. Turn the blade. Cut down. Look behind you. Shift. Cut up. Turn the blade. Cut down. Turn your right hand over. Step forward. Hook behind you. Pull it out. Put your feet, stab them, pull it out. Switch your right hand, forward as you step back with your right foot. And step back your left foot, bring it to your side. Put it away mostly, step back, lock it in, and back. Yeah? Any questions? No questions? Okay, let's watch one at a time. I want to see, let's see Evan.
I like the standing up starting better. It's kind of weird for me doing that.
Okay, that's fine. You can stand up.
I said two if you wanted to know. I just kind of.
That's good. That was good.
And then.
Good. Uh-huh. I think you need to switch your hands on that first cut there. So go back to that first cut on that side.
Wait, on this is supposed to be like this or this?
Your hand should be so on this first cut, remember your right hand is always highest.
Yeah. So that's what I did. Wait.
Yeah, but no, your right hand needs to be. Your right hand needs to be on top. See, so your right shoulder should be up higher than your left. Your right hand wants to be pointed up. So turn your hand over.
Like
so
that it's pointed. This?
Yeah, more like that. So it's more twisted up. I know it seems weird. Twisted up, yeah. Okay, now turn and go down. Okay, then. Good, poke, okay. Boom, nice. And then chaburi. Good. Excellent, nice work. Hey, you want me to watch you? Okay, let's watch Sensei.
Turn my sound back on for the questions.
Okay.
Oops. Shift. I can't get past that.
Switch hands. I know, space is an issue.
Yes. First up, out. Switch hands again. Dude, what do my feet do for this part?
That and you're just switching your feet, just like what you did.
Okay. Feet down.
You're gonna step all the way back as you do that chaburi.
Okay. I was stepping forward.
So step back with the right foot.
Right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
And then you're gonna step back again with your left as you put it away. So bring it across.
Left foot back behind.
So here's your chaburi. Right?
Yeah.
Step back and then bring it over.
Okay. Back with your left foot behind.
Yeah.
Like when you start. Okay.
So I know that the Bokens are kind of hard to work with because they're heavy, but try to, on that first strike, don't let your arm come back or up. Try to keep it horizontal. That's one thing that he looks for sure. Yes, like that. Oh, whoops. Yes, just like that. Okay, Evan, do you have any questions on that?
So wait, this isn't required.
It is not required. So you just got something that was additional off curriculum. It's called the Japanese cutting set.
When do you start like learning like swords, like actually like using them in other ways, like getting taught them?
Well, we don't really. We only have this cutting set. There's another sword kata that I learned from another instructor that we're starting to teach for the Kung Fu class. And then there's a Chinese broadsword, but we don't do swords for like self-defense or anything like that. We only have katas for swords. So, and those are all off curriculum for you guys. So the fact that you have this one is a bonus. Not a lot of the kids have it. So that's like, you know, something that you've got in your pocket. You can be like, hey, look what I'm going to do at tournament that nobody else has. So that's kind of cool, right? Mm-hmm. So it's just all extra bonus stuff that's just like nunchucks. Nunchucks aren't on the curriculum, but professor likes to teach it every now and then, that kind of thing. Does that make sense? Cool?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, cool. It's kind of fun to have a one-on-one class. All right, let's go ahead and bow out. All right, down position. And bada senseis, bada professor, bada dojo. And right foot out and elbows. Hey! And good. And we'll skip on the student creed. That's okay. All right, thank you. That was fun, guys. Thanks for indulging me on the sword.
Thanks.
All right. Bye, Evan.
Bye.